So approximately 4 inches or 10 centimeters, this is Boba Fett Morak from Star Wars The Vintage Collection. The reason why I've got this one out here for the eagle-eyed amongst you who may actually determine a little bit more that this is a different figure, this is one that I reviewed just a couple of weeks ago. This is the Tatooine Deluxe version, which across the globe seemed to cost an absolute fortune for some of these little accessories that you got with it. So a very expensive pack overall. But ultimately, what they've done here is found another avenue to get the Boba tax on us, get the Boba exclusivity going, and re-release the figure again. But, you know, to be fair, it is slightly different in its armour and the look and feel of the figure. So there is a measure of acceptableness with this. And it's Boba Fett, so of course it will sell. But this one here, as you can see, you know, removable helmet. Couple of blast effects and a couple of stormtrooper helmets really did not equate into such an extra high cost, but then again it's gone back into extra high cost by being exclusive again. I believe US Target, maybe it was Walmart, but I think it was Target. It's certainly translated to an Australian Target exclusive, a ridiculous $40-$50 priced figure. No idea whether this was exclusive in the UK or Europe, or if anyone's actually going to get their hands on it. We have had the previous retro version out there too, so a very simplistic rendition at 5 points of articulation, but nicely done on that card. So they've reused that card art there. So this is prior to him getting to Tatooine, and prior to any kind of scuffing on the final scenes that we get. So quite a few Boba Fetts there. It does say the Mandalorian, but I really thought this was actually the Book of Boba Fett, but I may be wrong. I think it probably was the Mandalorian episode. Still, you can see, and I'm not going to take this out of the package because it's exactly the same figure. We're getting the same blaster. There's no difference really in the blaster other than subtle paint differences. This is a silver tip. This did not. You obviously get the same helmet. You get the same jetpack. We get the same pistol, which is on the figure, so there's no difference in that. Where the differences lie, and let me just zoom in a little bit more, is primarily around the belt. So you can see there on this newer Morak version, we have same buckle, but slightly different kind of pellets on one side, pouches on the other. So not a great showstopper there. A slight difference in the kind of cummerbund-like way that it's on them. That's pretty much that. In terms of the legs, it's using, is it maybe using an earlier Fett? Either way, it's using the MC Hammer pants version. This one is more trousers. Other than that, the boots are the same. This time though, the Tatooine version has red spats. This one has kind of grey there with slightly muddier details. It is the same head sculpt, no major difference to it. The one here for Morak actually doesn't, it kind of shows him in a healthier position, whereas the one from Tatooine shows him as not quite super healed. So I think it really should have been the other way around. Either way, really incredibly good rendition of Tim Morrison. So much so, again, as I've said before in other interview reviews, and even to in interviews with Hasbro, why the Vintage Collection, such a small scale figure, can have such a nice matte, frankly perfect face. Really perfect, and yet the 6 inch is all waxy and sweaty, and it doesn't make sense. So it's a slightly different looking paint application there, but a bit more kind of eyes to the left, whereas this one is eye center. I mean, we're getting into real subtle stuff here. Same armor, same everything, it's just slightly different weathering, and that's your whack. That is it. You can see the gloves have a little bit of a red tinge on them in Morak. Do they in this one? They kind of do. No, they don't, actually. So there you go. No red-tinged gloves. Yeah, it's all really subtle. We're getting into really 50 shades of Boba here, but you get the point. So, yeah, I'm going to keep this one card, but there we go. I thought I'd give you a quick look and an explanation if you were not sure. Tatooine versus Morak. MC Hammer pants. I guess you could see the soft goods there. And the cummerbund belt is the real difference, as well as the paint on the legs. All on the lower half, shall we say. That's it for me. Let us know what you think of this. I will put a link underneath the video where you can possibly buy it. Let us know what countries, if any, you were able to get this. But yeah, quite a premium one, this to get hold of. Bit of a pain in the ass. But there you go. Let us know. We'll see you for more coming up soon.